The Kansas City bar in Tijuana, Mexico, the Kansas City stops.
And here we go.
Decided the brass don't need the microphone, they're loud enough. thanks, that was the Kansas City stomp. And now we're going to play something a little more laid back. It's one of Jelly Roll Morton's most beautiful compositions from 1930, and it features John Wurr, and it's entitled The Blue Blood Blues.
Thank you.
This was in the tradition of his mentor Tony Jackson. He used to play fast, raggy pieces for the naked dances in the brothels. And I don't think we're licensed for naked dancing here, but so just restrain yourself. Anyway, this is another entitled The Finger Buster, during which my fingers shall not leave my wrists.
Thank you.
me not to remind you that my CD is for sale, of course. Because it's the same one, Falling Castle, if you haven't got that. But Robin's got that. But if you haven't got it, well worth having. Lots of the same notes on it, and high-speed tunes. And I've got one or two of me with Bill Greeno as well, doing a kind of a Sydney Bechet thing, and another one with French chanson, or something different for you. But anyway, plug over. There will be no more advertisements during this set. Now I'd like to invite the band back, and with our special guest edition, Mr. Alan Barnes.
Yeah.
Alan Barnes is wearing his special guest's jacket. John Wurr has bought some shoes, especially for tonight's session. So, between us, we have a kind of band uniform.
Hey, Martin.
Martin.
No, it's that.
So we're going to play one of Morton's lesser-known numbers now from 1930, and it's a thing called Crazy Chords. Perhaps in the year 2001, they don't sound quite as crazy as they did in 1930, but sort of set your minds back then. New parts for some of the chaps, and I'm not sure all the cuts have been indicated, so this could be interesting geographically, but you don't need to know that. This is a number which Jelly Roll Morton would have heard in his youth on the streets of New Orleans. All the marching bands played it. It's a thing called High Society, and John Wurr will say the famous clarinet part, which of course was adapted from a piccolo part by Alphonse Picou.
Thank you.
never even imagined it. Another one of Jelly's most beautiful tunes here, a thing called Sweet Anita Mine, which he dedicated to his common law wife, Anita Gonzalez, who he kind of knew from New Orleans. She was the sister of Bill Johnson, who was King Oliver's bass player. And he lived with her in California, I think, between about 1918 and 1923. And then they kind of fell out, and he didn't see her again until 1940. And she kind of was there at his deathbed, and he left all his money to her, much to the disgruntlement of his other common law wife, Mabel Bertram. Anyway, these facts are very in dispute. Anyway, this is a great number, Sweet Anita Mine.
Thank you.
No, Jelly Roll Morton was once said in his theorising on jazz that the guys were always trying to think of new ways of entertaining the public, and they'd introduce all kinds of novelty effects. And he recorded a session in about 1927 where he did three numbers where they had a kind of an animal impersonator, Mr. Lou Lamar, and they did Hyena Stomp, Wild Man Blues, and the Billy Goat Stomp. And when the band's had a drink, it has been known to do the Billy Goat noises. So, yes, I think we could be lucky tonight. Bob Hunt there at the end. Yeah. Wonderful Stump Evans style alto from Alan Barnes there. Yeah. And John Wurr doing the Johnny Dodge bit very well. Yeah, excellent. And of course, Nick Ward at the drums doing the Paul on the spot. So we'd like to end this first set on a Jelly Roll Morton number. It was really kind of 20 years ahead of its time. He was using riff patterns and call and response that the swing bands were doing in the swing era in the 30s. But he wrote this number in 1905, and it's the remarkable King Porter Stomp. Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, dear chant, and now a number that we're playing. It's a special request, but we're going to play it anyway, despite that. It's known from Morton's recording as the Smokehouse Blues, but actually it was a tune written by one Ross Reynolds and entitled Creole, and Morton stole it and entitled it the Smokehouse Blues. And of course, he was always beefing on about people stealing his material, but he was not adverse to it himself. So, Bark and Handel did it, so yeah, it's fair game. Yes, a good musical precedent there. So here it is, the Smokehouse Blues, and this is full of novelty effects, as usual, like the false ending. So first one to clap is a sissy. The girls working there. I'd like to the numbers to be a little spicier, you know, so we'd write things with rude lyrics, things like the Whining Boy Blues. And so this number is really in that tradition. It's entitled Sweet Peter. Mike Henry there on the trumpet there, Sweet Peter. I'm going to give most of the guys a rest now, and we'd like to feature a very fine clarinet player playing with the band for the first time and doing a wonderful job, Mr. John Wurr. Yeah. And John is going to join Nick Ward and myself to play another entitled The Shreveport Stomp, which was originally recorded in 1928 with Homer Simeon, Tommy Benford at the drums, and of course Jelly Roll Morton. The Reeds, BBC Instrumentalist of the Year, but we know him as Barnsley, Alan Barnes. It's one that reminds me of the soundtrack of a Laurel and Hardy movie, which can't be a bad thing. Yes, one of the great things in the life, apart from Jelly Roll Morton's Red Hot Peppers, Laurel and Hardy. Thank you.
I should come and see it again tomorrow.
We have Kleiner Pals, why it was the Bob Hunt lights his cigar.
Yeah. See, the thing is, the Temperance Seven, in their heyday, were sponsored by King Edwards.
So there's a potato.
Well,
It's a kind of a piece of deliberate primitivism on Jelly Roll Morton's part. He was quite good at writing the odd tune where almost nothing happens. There's another one, Monrovia, which is all on one chord. Anyway, there aren't many more chords in this one. Jungle Blues.
Thank you.
the jungle blues. Now, like a lot of New Orleans musicians, Jelly Roll Morton made the migration to Chicago, where the greatest job opportunities in the 20s, and he wrote a number in praise of that city called Chicago Breakdown, but also recorded it as a piano solo entitled Stratford Hunch. So we're going to play that number for you now. And, I've written lots of kind of Louis Armstrong style hot links for the trumpet here, which should give Mike something to think about.
And we
did, yeah. Bob and I used to have a band called Chicago Breakdown. Yeah, well, what happened to them? Say no more. Anyway, here it is, the Chicago Breakdown or Stratford Hunch. classic solo from Mike Henry there. Yeah. Okay, well, I'm not going to announce this next number, I'm just going to let it happen. It features a certain amount of Pokemon hilarity, as they used to call it.
What's that I hear? 12 o'clock in the daytime, church bells ringing. Oh man, you don't hear no church bells ringing? 12 o'clock at the daytime? Don't tell me, someone must be dead. There ain't nobody dead. Somebody must be dead drunk. Don't tell me, I think there's a funeral. Now look here, I believe I do hear a funeral. I believe I hear that trombones, bones.
Okay, the last of the great hams there, Mike Henry and Bob Hunt. And we'd like to end this set on one of Jelly's high-speed tunes with an appropriate title. It's Burning the Iceberg. And then we'll see you after a very short interval. And I still have CDs on sale. I haven't noticed anyone clamouring to the stand yet.
Where are they?
Oh, yes, I'll get them out later. And the CDs. Yes, right. I'll do anything to make a sound. Right. Moving swiftly on, Burning the Iceberg.
Right. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Now, the defining Morton piece, the original Jelly Roll Blues, which he kind of wrote in praise of himself. Not a modest man, Jelly Roll Morton. Of course, he claimed to have invented jazz in the year 1902, to be precise. And he wrote this number and played it around Chicago. James B. Johnson remembers him playing this in Chicago, in New York, in 1911. And he said he arrived with a couple of prostitutes on his arm, and he was doing a bit of pimping, and his diamond was flashing in his tooth. And he was into all kinds of glorious pursuits, Jelly Roll Morton. Of course, he was a great pool player on the side. And, in those days, piano playing was really just like a kind of sideline for him. It was only until he moved to Chicago and Al Capone had the whole scene sewn up, and he couldn't really do his pool hustling or pimping, and he had to sort of think about being a serious musician, which was to our advantage, really. And here is his wonderful tune, the original Jelly Roll Blues, which has a touch of the Spanish tinge, as he called it.
The Spanish tinge.
Yes, gentian and violence fix it usually, I find.
Pitching out, very fine clarinet player, and well, it's another one of those double entendre titles, and it's a thing called Stroking Away. About to tell you about Stroking Away, but the imagination is much better. Yes. They'll work it out for themselves.
Right.
You see, the thing is that Martin is a very erudite and very educated, well-educated man. And my old pal as well. And
not for much longer.
And this number called Stroking Away is a lovely little tune. And we all like it. And we all, yeah, we all like to be stroking away. And I suppose you've all figured out what it means. Stroking away.
Very well put, Bob. Yeah. Very well put, Bob. Yeah.
Thanks!
Bob! You're not too funny.
This number, dedicated it to her, and it's called The Pearls. Here's another unusual Morton item from 1930, and it's a thing called Oil Well, which was a tune dedicated to his manager at the time, when Harrison Smith, who had shares in an oil company, hence Oil Well. It's been lovely playing for you. Thanks for turning up. We're at the Heartland Hotel tomorrow, where we play the same numbers in a different order. including Monrovia. Yeah, we left a few out tonight, so we'll have some different things to play to you. I still have CDs left, if you'd like to, you know, rush to the bandstand. Yeah. And one more time for these wonderful musicians. At the trombone, Mr. Bob Hunt. Mike Henry at the trumpet. John Wurr. Alan Barnes. Graham Reed at the sousaphone. Nick Ward, drums. And Spats Langham. There's the clap on with us rising now. And this is a thing called Wolverine Blues, which isn't a blues at all. But there we are. There was a lot of that going on in the 20s. Thank you. and we'll be at the Heartland Hotel tomorrow.